Hey guys, and welcome back to TurboSelectDX discussing Marvel's Capcom Infinite. Now let's get back to Jeremy's thoughts.
With this, the info that they put out, the modes that they're doing with the Marvel's Capcom Infinite, and it seems like what I'm seeing here is that they're learning from their experience with Street Fighter V, with its lack of content, is that they're including a decent amount of single player stuff, arcade mode, story mode, training, obviously, mission mode. So right off the bat, you're getting an arcade.
Hey,
mode.
speaking of all that. Do you think that they're gonna combine like the Capcom Fighting Network, whatever? Do you think that's gonna work with that too?
That's all right. See, that's what I'm hoping that they do, because they started that with Street Fighter V, and I'm hoping that they carry it on over into their other fighting games, which also ties into the fact that I'm hoping, because right now they got Capcom Cup, right?
Yeah.
They got Capcom Cup going on that they introduced for Street Fighter 4, and now they're doing it with Street Fighter 5. What I'm hoping that they do is they support any other fighting games that they come out with the Capcom Pro Tour, because you only got Street Fighter 5. You have another game coming out that people love and people play competitively, which is going to be Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite. Put that in your lineup for the Capcom Pro Tour. It doesn't just have to be Street Fighter. You can introduce other games that you put out. So there you go. There's another game to introduce into the competitive scene to support, not just only, you know, by putting it out, obviously, but make it a part of the CFN. Make it a part of the Capcom Pro Tour.
Well, see, the thing is about the CFN is, like, I always thought they created it as, like, a system for the PS4 and the Steam players to, like, connect. Mm-hmm. But, with it coming out to Xbox, like, if they reuse the CFN, like, obviously, there's a whole thing, like, you know, other platform games can't connect to each other, but Sony and Microsoft also came out and said, like, hey, we're cool with the idea, but, you know, they're not probably going to implement it anytime soon.
Yeah.
Like, it just makes me curious, is all.
See, here's the thing with CFN. Keep in mind, Street Fighter V is on PC as well.
I said
so that carries on, yeah, that's what I'm saying. The CFN works on both.
Yeah.
There's nothing that, like, if it was on Xbox, the CFN is their own thing.
Yeah, that's what I was getting at. I was like, I'm hoping, like, it, like, connects the different platforms together, including Xbox. Yeah. Because that would be, like, a first, and that would be awesome.
That's kind of, I mean, I see what you're saying, but that's kind of an answer to your own question, because they already are doing that with the PC version.
That's if they use it, though.
The PS4 version. If they do it, obviously, yes. But it'd be that's something that I would like to see them do, is include it not just with, you know, the CFN, but also with the Capcom Pro Tour. Yes. You have a huge competitive scene. Fucking
Halo Man of Xbox.
Show that you can support not just Street Fighter, because they didn't do it with Marvel vs. Capcom 3. They didn't do it with that game. But yeah, you got those single player modes, the single player content. You got the multiplayer content, your typical ranked casual matches, leaderboards, online lobbies, spectator mode, all that bullshit.
That's cool.
Some more info that was put out is that it's using Unreal Engine 4.
Oh my
for
god.
This game. Yeah. So Unreal Engine 4 is getting used a lot for fighting games.
It looks like the Japanese are actually good at using it.
Yeah, because
they can actually make like different colors other than brown.
Yeah, exactly. And people like to shit talk Unreal Engine all the time. There
it's fucking
go.
Beautiful,
what
man.
What did they use for made, Guilty you, Gear?
Yeah, exactly.
They what used they use it for Guilty Gear? That was Unreal 3 though, wasn't it?
No, Unreal Engine 4.
Was it 4? Okay.
Yeah.
But yeah, still, the Japanese developers got it. I'm like, hey, faggots, why don't you, like, do this? I'm like, what? You mean tell me to turn it 90 degrees to the right?
Yeah. Well, wow. Didn't Marvel 3 use, time. Like, that, the, what was it, the Mega Man Trigger Engine or whatever, the MT Network? Or Framework, whatever it was?
MT Framework.
Marvel's Capcom 3.
That's the thing people have been talking about, is that Marvel 3 used MT Framework. Now for Marvel Infinite, it's going to be a completely different graphics engine that they're using. We know fucking Unreal Engine 4. We know what it can do. I'm pretty sure they know what it can do. We've seen what it can do with Guilty Gear. Guilty Gear is like probably the best example for a fighting game in terms of Unreal Engine. Cause like, look at that shit, man. It's fucking that game is gorgeous.
Look, it gets you like up in the morning.
I look at Eno. Take
oh yeah,
it, up
it gets
the
me
ass,
up in the morning.
I look at Eno take it up the ass by Faust Figure. I'm just like, yeah, that's what I like to see.
Yeah, this is why they made this.
Yeah, exactly. But
for Faust is a fucking move.
that's just some of the info that got put out that I just wanted to cover real quick.
All right, it's stupid. Let's talk about characters.
Yeah, let's get to the fucking meat and potatoes of the fucking.
Let's talk about the thing.
The fucking thing that everybody loves to speculate whenever a new video game comes
out. All right, my first choice, Super Saiyan
Shut
Goku.
Shut the fuck up, I'm not done.
Super Saiyan God Goku.
Wait, what?
Yes.
Sengoku?
Super Saiyan Goku, let's go.
Oh, I thought you said Sengoku.
AKA Captain Marvel. No, I was kidding.
Yeah, let's put in Cloud and Bayonetta.
Alright, go ahead, Jeremy, my bad.
But either way, we're fucking... The best part of this topic in any fighting game speculation is the characters. We want to know who the fuck's in. We want to get the characters that we want in, you know, all that shit. So I'm going to save myself for last, because I already know what I want to say. Let's go on straight. Let's fucking switch, turn the tables here. Jeff, who the fuck do you want in this game?
High Punch Ryu.
Punch Ryu. Wait, what?
No, that's the different colors. High Punch is like his light blue color. That's stupid. It's hard to think of Marvel characters, because when you think about it, of the entirety of the Verse series has always been mutants.
Yeah, they included.
If you think about every single Verse series game, it's always been either mutants or X-Men characters, right? Or like some Fantastic Four just being Doom, I think.
Yeah, they always took up a large portion of the Marvel roster.
Now we shouldn't think comics. We should think movies now.
Because
that's what they're fucking pushing.
That's a good point, actually.
You should think that, yeah. But you should also.
So you're gonna
keep in mind both, though.
So you got to keep in mind who's obviously gonna come back: Captain America, Spider-Man, Iron Man, clearly.
Mm-hmm.
Marvel. I'd like to see. I don't know. For Marvel, you know what? I'm not even gonna say because I don't know enough Marvel's characters.
Yeah.
Maybe Hawkeye will come back.
I'm pretty sure Hawkeye will make a comeback.
Oh, Hulk's definitely gonna be in there. He's always.
Yeah.
Hulk. Oh man, I definitely want to see Ant-Man return after, especially seeing the movie. The movie was way too good, and like that.
Don't just limit this to the movies. Think about the TV shows as well.
I don't watch TV shows, really.
TV shows, well, Netflix, cinema, all that good stuff.
The Netflix series. So you got fucking, you know, thank Daredevil, thank fucking Luke Cage, Jessica Jones.
I'm sure whatever's popular right now, they're going to try to stuff in because that's what's big. So, like I said, I don't really have much of the Marvel side, but Capcom, there's like a gazillion characters I could think of. I wonder, with Mega Man, X is obviously in it, and what's the trend they've been doing for every Verse series game? It's been only, two Mega Man characters, I think. Roll in Mega Man.
There's not always, there's not usually a trend, it's just like...
Well, that's the biggest trend I can think
they'll
of.
They'll put in whoever, because Marvel 2 had 3 Mega Man characters.
Oh, no! Bring Servbot back!
Oh, fucking yeah, 4! They had 4 characters!
Yo, Servbot!
Yeah, bring the Servbot so that he can get slammed to the ground, like in that gif of Cyclops. I love that gif.
Honestly, as far as Mega Man characters, bringing them back, anyone from, I think more of them from the X series. Yeah. I don't know if they're going to actually bring Zero back, though, to be honest.
Yeah.
I always felt that with Mega Man characters, it was always like a generational thing, like, you had Mega Man Classic, and then you had, Roll, and then you had, Trombon and Servbot, so that's, Legends. And then Marvel's Capcom 3, you had...
What about Tatsunoko,
though? Tatsunoko, you had Classic Roll, and then you had Dash. Cool. And then in 3, you had Zero and Trombon. Zero. Yeah, I keep forgetting.
It might not be a generational thing, because I heard I saw a leak the other day for this game where they were just like, yeah, there. It was found in the game in this that they saw when they were, I guess, the leak mentioned the game that Roll's song is in it, the one from Marvel 1. So
have you heard that song recently? It's so good.
It's a pretty decent mm-hmm. song.
It's
but...
a real like. By the way, what about Diesel?
Teaselbon? Yeah, I'd like that guy.
I really would love to bring
expand on the Bond character. Family, because they have a lot of good characters.
No, or, you know, general, finish the story of Mega Man Legends through Marvel vs. Capcom.
Wait, Teasel gets announced in, Mega Man Legends 3.
Oh, bro. Could you imagine? He doesn't. They don't even just allude to it through story mode. Diesel just gets announced, and he's like, "Mega Man Legends 3 is alive."
and then CEO comes back down and puts that piece of paper on Joe Schmo's desk, and he's like, "Go ahead, leak it again."
For Marvel vs. Capcom 3, we got characters like Firebrand and Nemesis. I'd love to see characters that don't get more outside of their one game.
Yeah.
Nemesis, for Nemesis, technically speaking, I think he only got out of like one other game, and I hate Operation Raccoon City.
Oh my gosh, shut up!
Anyway, it was cool to have Nemesis now. I would love to have something like that again. You know what, actually? Maybe the Tyrant or Veronica.
Yeah.
That would be neat. I'd like to see Chris return. Chris was fun in 3. But some people are like, Leon, and I'm like, I don't know. Leon's kind of a fuckboy, and I don't like him.
Leon, how about six. Jake? Let's get Jake in there.
Jake, yeah, right? You know what? Jake makes more sense in a fighting game because he's already like zipping across the room and shit.
But he doesn't do the same thing Daddy does. He can't teleport like that.
No, yeah, but he can't.
But he's voiced by Troy Baker, so it makes him better, right?
Yeah, if your character's voiced by Troy Baker, that automatically means you're a good character.
He's more Sherry.
That, you know what? Wait, think about it. Who are they going to replace Sentinel with him? Like, for a big...
In terms
robot.
Of a big robot, there's rumors of Ultron.
The fucking they did with Tatsunoko.
There's rumors of Ultron being in, which would make sense. Because you
How
know this whole
he's not that big at all.
He's not that big. He's probably
Iron Man suit.
He's tall. He's taller than your average person. But,
even in the comics.
Yeah,
in
he's
the
maybe
comics,
like
that big.
The dude, he did Ultron is maybe like.
You know I can see being that big character?
7 foot. I don't know.
You know I can see being that big character? That fucking enemy, or the main bad guy for the first like Thor movie, that like watcher of the fucking like safe. He was like
Destroyer,
a... He was kind of like a big Sentinel-ish character.
For Capcom.
If that's the case, they might as well just put the Ice Giants in. Fuck that guy.
Yeah, but I'm talking the Capcom, not the Marvel side.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you were
saying...
Because you said Sentinel, so...
I'm gonna be really depressed not to see Sentinel actually, because I'm so used to that stupid robot.
Sentinel's Marvel, bro.
Yeah, you did say.
You were on
Capcom,
you know,
and you just started talking about.
I'm all fucked up here.
It's okay. This is the podcast where we realize we're fucked up.
You think Akuma? Like, they're gonna put Akuma in?
Yeah.
He seems to be really busy this year.
I mean, with him being in Tekken 7 and just recently revealed from Street Fighter 5,
he's everywhere, man.
A little bit.
He's everywhere.
Yeah, but yeah,
actually,
possible.
Billy Cohen. I would like Billy Cohen from Zero.
Billy Cohen?
Yeah.
From Mario
Zero.
Zero.
He's
way too
cool not to put in.
He's all right.
He's literally designed to be cool and to
he's
say
not,
things.
He's
cool.
Okay.
He's stronger than Rebecca and can move boxes.
That's true. He's stronger than
random people. Mortar guy from Resident Evil. That they cut.
Man. Yeah.
It's hard to talk about complete character.
Think about it.
I definitely want, they added Firebrand, Nemesis. I like shit like that again. Just something you don't fucking see.
Those obscure characters that you don't see.
Nemesis isn't that obscure, but yeah, Firebrand's definitely way more obscure than Nemesis.
No one's. Didn't see him coming at all.
When I say obscure, it's the characters you don't think of. Because when you say Resident Evil, think Nemesis.
When I think Resident Evil.
Well, you, yes. I know you because you're a fucking weirdo. No, I'm just kidding.
Nemesis is like one of the greatest Resident Evil characters ever. Like monster wise, he's like one of the most popular ones.
Yeah.
Shit, I had it in my head, too.
Is there anybody else that you can think of that you would possibly want? Someone that you really, really want.
Someone from Power Stone.
Oh, yes!
I've seen people mention that they want to see, like, Power Stone get some sort
That's
of love.
That's impossible. Like, why the fuck?
Nothing's impossible when you could put Hayato in a Marvel game, because I know it was Marvel 2, and at the time, the Dreamcast and Hayato was like at the height of his
relevant
like, his relevance. But still,
Bring Strider.
Nobody played Star Gladiator.
No one cares.
Bro, I would love to see a Power Stone character. What was the main character's dude's name? Falco? Falcon?
Falcon, I think it was.
He was so Falcon. Cool. He was so cool.
Well, since you're
Power Stone. Jesus
Jeffy,
Christ.
Welcome
Jeffy
to Power Stone Raw.
I don't want Captain Commando back, I can tell you that.
Fuck you! Fuck you!
Alright, hold on. That's his opinion, but to be fair, right now we're talking about who you want in, not who you don't want in.
Okay. Dan, fuck actually. You know why? You know why I want him back? So he can do his premium sign thing, because he only
stupid taunt super.
Dude, he only ever does the sign, where he signs something.
I love that. I do love that, because like, I always make fun of it, because every time the sound he makes, every time he throws, he's like, ooga!
You notice back in the old... Okay, with all the Verse series games, not all of them, but Marvel vs. Capcom 1 and 2, you had those characters that weren't that great. Like, Dan wasn't great. I can't think about a Marvel vs. Capcom 1 who wasn't that good. Mm-hmm. But you had characters that were kind of jokey, like Servbot. I'd like something like that.
Yeah.
You don't always have to be serious about the, you know, the picks. It'd be kind of funny. True.
Doesn't hurt to have a
chance. Yeah, I got nothing else to be honest, though.
Matt,
I
since
think,
you.
Like, evil tyrants, but.
Yeah. Matt, since you threw out a suggestion out there with Power Stone and Falcon, I mean, who else would you want to see?
I mean, like, I wasn't even thinking about Power Stone until Jeff said anything, so, I mean, like, that's all on him. But,
well,
I mean,
course,
like, on.
You still said Falcon, though.
Yeah, because, like, he was, like, my favorite Power Stone character, like, aside from Yami. I think that was her name. But like on the Capcom side, I would like to see Captain Commando come back, because he was like, I don't say he was Capcom's like mascot, but I mean his like name Captain Commando, like always Capcom, like he was always like, for me, he was always enjoyable to play, like in Marvel 1 and 2, like he was just, he had so many different things going on. He had like his fire blast, the little fucking, the Captain Sword, the fucking little little electricity like blasted the ground, his teammates coming in, like he was such a versatile character, and I fucking loved him. Like, he had that attitude about him. Like, if they can bring back fucking Spencer for fucking Marvel's Capcom 3, I don't see why they can't bring. I mean, their aesthetics are almost the same. Like, their aesthetics are almost the same. Spencer and fucking Captain Commando. Like, you have like the bulkier upper body, like because of the fucking like equipment they have on their arms and shit
but
that.
Spencer's good though.
Shut the fuck.
No,
up.
No, see, here's the difference in terms of game. In terms of gameplay, Marvel,
yeah.
In terms of in terms of gameplay for Marvel 3, if anyone was pretty much Captain Commando, it was Viper. So you know,
yeah,
she didn't have a Captain Corridor, but she had the Seismo. She had a weird ass fireball, but it was a fire.
That's why I said their aesthetics. Their aesthetics.
Yeah, But go on.
I'm just saying Spencer's better though.
No, like I would Captain Commando. I mean, I agree with Jeff. Like someone for Power Stone. I would like another Mega Man character, but maybe not from the same generation, like, maybe not from the X series, maybe from, like, even, like, the classic one, I would like to see, like, Bass maybe make an appearance for once, like, that dude, talking about Mega Man X, like, dropping off the fucking side of the earth and never coming back, like, Bass was, like, never mentioned again, like, ever, unless you count, like, Vio as, like, Mega Man X's Bass or some shit like that, but,
you
like...
You know, like, they're not gonna do it unless it's popular.
I mean, like... I mean, they're bringing X back, and X. I mean, X is a popular character. All the Mega Man characters, like in my opinion, like Classic and X, and even Zero, were popular characters. They were just irrelevant in the time because they didn't have a game in so long. Like, if they're bringing back an X, if they're bringing X back, which is a fan favorite. I mean, like Bass was like one of the favorite, like a fan favorite. And as you said before, Jeff, like you want to see like a more like villain like or villainous like upkeep like of characters in fucking Marvel vs. Capcom. I mean,
I don't remember saying that, but it sounds like something.
Well, you said with the Sentinel and stuff like that.
He just said more characters from the series.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It'd be cool to have more obscure ones. What, Vile? Adding him?
No, not Vile. I mean, I want Bass, personally. Or Bass, whatever.
Well, here's the question when you say Bass. See, now, do you want just regular, like, original Mega Man Bass, or do you want Bass EXE?
I mean, Bass EXE was obviously like a fucking baller.
Okay.
Like he got all the bitches.
Like, he was way cool.
Yeah, he was. Anything from EXE or what are the other handhelds? Any other handhelds are gonna get added?
Well, the magical thing, Jeff, about Bass from the EXE series is that like his overall design really wasn't that different, aside from like a cloak. So you can like kind of pull it off.
It was actually significantly, well, not significantly, but it was significantly different.
He was like he was a bit sleeker.
Come on, be realistic.
One, he was taller. Two, he had those like weird looking like those kind of cool like boots to his outfit. And yeah, the best part of it was the cloak. He had the cloak, and that shit was dope. But like, I mean, I remember I was watching Super Best Friends play Command Mission, Mega Man X Command Mission. Shout out to Super Best Friends, go watch them. But there was an episode where they were just sitting there talking about Mega Man EXE, and the whole entire time they're just like, "Yo, these designs for every character in EXE is so cool."
Yeah, they were.
It's
cool.
True.
They were.
EXE cool. Like Battle Network had good fucking designs.
No, base was one of the better looking ones in EXE, but I still think Command Mission Mega Man X was still the best one, like, ever. He was a bit bulky, but he was balling his shit. Like
that scarf, man.
Yeah.
Scarf,
man.
But moving on from that, with the Marvel side, I'm not entirely sure what I want. But if we're gonna see Spider-Man make a return, I would like to see Venom come back.
Oh, because
he was like, he played drastically different from Spider-Man, and he was just like overall like a cooler character. We are Venom. Like he was just he was just so cool. Like especially in Marvel 1 and 2, like he was.
Isn't he actually stronger than Spider-Man?
Yes.
Like he did more damage, yeah.
Yes.
And like even if like you don't want to like overload the game with like villains, because like I think with Marvel 3, like majority of the villains are on like the Marvel side.
Yeah.
If I remember correctly, like Venom's like he's kind of like he, you know, villain turn anti-hero turn like I do the right thing every so often kind of guy, you know. I would like to see Venom come back, but
yeah.
I know this is like a far fetch from it, but I would like to see what they kind of did with Marvel 2 come back to Marvel 4 if, or Marvel Infinite if possible, which is most likely not going to happen, and I know it's a stretch, but I would like to see like maybe like a character made specifically for that game, kind of like what they did with Ruby Heart
and Mingo.
Yeah, like I would kind of like to see something like that come back, because like for the longest time I thought they were Capcom characters. I did not know they were made for just that game for the story.
Well, a Mingo actually wasn't made for Marvel's Capcom. He was supposed to be. He was a Darkstalkers character originally, and they just carried him over into Marvel 2.
He was supposed Ruby to Heart, be a Darkstalkers character.
Ruby Heart is. Yeah, he was supposed to be
That's so fucking
Think
dumb.
About it. Think about it. There are a lot of characters in Darkstalkers that are dumb, and he's
yeah,
not
but
that
no
much...
was that fucking stupid.
Hey, Amingo's cool. I love Amingo.
Yeah, I like him too, but look at his stupid hat. He's the little versions of himself.
But, yeah, Ruby Heart was made for specifically for Street Fighter.
I mean,
Street Fighter.
And personally,
which,
I would like to see that.
Ship. They went to go fight the evil.
Fun fucking fact. Even though Ruby Heart made her appearance and was originally meant for Marvel's Capcom 2, they recently updated onto the CFN. They put a picture and a profile for Ruby Heart. So now, technically, Ruby Heart is part of the Street Fighter universe.
Which makes no fucking sense.
It makes perfect sense. Shut the fuck
How
up.
How does it make sense?
Who cares? Ruby Heart's great.
Does anyone ask Ryu, hey, what was all your crazy adventures like?
Oh, I ran the pirates. You know, they were cool.
I beat the ultimate evil.
But either, yeah, whatever. Matt, you got any other characters
I
you want to see?
I mean, one more for Capcom side, because I'm not too knowledgeable about too much Marvel. I mean, I'm pretty sure you're going to hit that one out of the park. But, I mean, I would like to see Jin come back. He was just such a hyped character. And yeah, so energetic. Yeah. And he like seeing him come back would be so cool.
That's all you got?
Yeah. Jin, right. Captain Commando.
Okay, for me, huh? Alright, let's see what I have here. Tatsunoko, they had the Lost Planet mech. That would be cool. Bring that dude back. I already went over the Mega Man skins. Django.
Oh my god. Let go.
From like what?
From fucking Boktai, get out of here.
Bro.
Django is deader than Bomberman, and Bomberman's company literally went under. Stop. I love Boktai just as much as you, Fred, but there is no Taiyo here. There is no sunlight in his world. He is dead. Moving on.
This not even have anything to do with him being dead.
No, it doesn't.
Company.
It doesn't, but I'm going to bring it up every time.
Bro, come on.
Every time.
We're not. No, he's gone.
Oh my god,
dead
you know what?
Dead. He's
if
dead.
This was
dirt.
Like that other game. Where they took like fucking a Maui head versus Simon Belmont versus some other bullshit. Maybe.
Yeah.
That fucking game, maybe.
Dude, like, stop bringing up Django. That motherfucker, like, Konami took him out back and put a bullet in his head a long time ago. Let it go.
Here's the kicker.
Really
he didn't die immediately.
Trouble. They probably forgot about him.
He didn't die immediately. He's still bleeding out right now in the backyard.
He's like, somebody remember me, please.
Remember that DS game they had? Not Konami.
Lunar Knight, shut up. It was like one of the better Boktai games out there.
So, you got anything else for it?
Okay, this is never gonna happen, but I just like to say it. A Monster Hunter, anything?
Yes.
That's
be nice.
Maybe bring the Double Joe as a big character.
That's not, well, if they do the characters, but
the
that's
closest
not far
we've
off of
ever
a
gotten. The only closest thing we've ever gotten to a Monster Hunter was what, Sophie or whatever from Dawn from fucking Onimusha. That's the closest I could think of to how a Monster Hunter would play.
Yeah.
To be completely honest with you. That's probably the only thing I can think of.
Only without the voodoo black magic shit.
See, if they had it'd be cool if they did add Monster Hunter to the roster of characters because they should make him be like a stance character where he can change his weapons. Kind of like how Amaterasu and Marvel
Dante.
3 did. But Dante was based, he didn't change styles and weapons.
His weapons just
completely.
Chained together. Or his
like,
attacks.
Amaterasu changed her weapon. She used the whip, she had the fucking shield, and she had the sword. Or not the whip, it was the fucking. The ice shooting shit. Either way, whatever. She had that. She had different weapons that you could switch back and forth between. I'd like to see if they included Mothra in it for them to do that. But yeah, go on, Fred. That's not.
We were talking about this the other day. Azura. Is that what you said?
Azura.
From Azura's Wrath.
Yeah, he would be really cool to bring back. Like that game was pretty ballin', and
he's in high demand right now. A lot of people
want
him.
He would definitely fit. What's going on? We already talked about Captain Commando. Devil May Cry, I would like to see Nero as some representation, you know, that would be cool, but that's not gonna happen.
You just want a grabby arm.
I want a grabby arm, man. Let's go.
You just want Blaze Blue, is that what you want?
Yes, let's get Blaze Blue. Infernal Devices, let's go.
Oh my god.
So I'm gonna use this moment real quick to remind everybody that in Marvel 2 there was two Wolverines. Continue, Fred.
Yes, there were.
Bone Claw and fucking Metal.
Bone Claw and Adamantium Wolverine. They were two different ones, and one of them had one super exclusive to him, which was Adamantium. He had a Berserker charge. Go on.
For Marvel, really? I don't, like, Matt, I don't really have too many, but like Jeff said, Ant-Man would be really cool.
Where does Blackheart fall in the, like, spectrum of Marvel characters and who owns them?
Ghost Rider. It's a Ghost Rider character.
Who does Ghost Rider, like, fall under?
Marvel?
No, I mean like what company is currently like owning the rights to like license this shit?
Sony?
Marvel?
You mean movies, right?
Like yes, like Marvel? The movies.
Marvel Studios?
Is it purely Sony. Marvel Studios? Is not Sony or fucking Fox or whatever?
Ghost Rider was in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Yeah, he was in that show, so he's
okay.
Cool.
I don't
he's
watch
cool.
that show, so
he's cool.
Okay.
Daredevil with his gun and his empty
and
gun
chain.
And his chain. Yep. And I would personally like to see Luke Cage. That would be cool.
Power Man.
You don't got anybody else? Anybody from a particular game series in a particular tiny mech
okay.
with tiny
robots? You know that goes without saying. That's like saying... I say Django and Tron Bonne. Let's go. She's coming back.
Oh, Tron Bonne. I thought
he
meant Sakura.
Don't worry, she's coming back. She's coming back.
I hope she comes back, honestly. I'd like to see Tron Bonne too, but... Got anything else for it?
Or Police Girl.
That ain't gonna happen. That's asking too much.
Yeah,
no
one knows who the fuck she is.
What about Ryo from Shenmue?
Right. Anyway, Fred, you got any more? I'm just gonna sandbag the fuck out of that.
Yeah, now.
Fred, you got any more?
I know someone mentioned it earlier, but like, yeah, there is a shit ton of X-Men characters in Marvel.
Yeah,
holy
yeah,
crap.
There's a lot.
Because I'm looking
They take up the majority of the cast.
Yeah, I'm looking at the 2 roster right now. There's so many.
In each game, they always take up the majority of the cast.
The 2 Wolverines, Cyclops, Mauro, Psylocke.
With the exception of, I think... Actually,
Iceman. Colossus. No, not yeah, Colossus, fucking Juggernaut, Magneto, Storm,
yeah.
Omega Red.
That thing.
Fucking
anyway.
Rogue, Rouge, whatever.
Oh, yeah,
Sabretooth.
Luke Cage, that's it, Fred? That's all you got?
That's all I got.
All right.
Let's go, Jeremy. Let's go.
I got a few that I really want to see. One in particular, I want to see Lady from Devil May Cry. That'd be awesome. I think they need to do a lot of things with all her cool gun stuff, especially since they made her a playable character in the special edition of Devil May Cry 4.
That's why I said Nero.
Who? Nero? Oh, yeah, that makes sense. But really? There's Dante and Virgil.
Yeah, but Nero. Come on.
You're right. You know
Fred.
What? Make.
Fred, do you know how much Capcom acknowledges Nero? All right.
Three Devil May Cry representatives: Nero, Lady, and Dante. Trish, I want Nero, but.
Don't you, Trish, again.
Well, no, that's why I'm saying Lady. I want Lady over Trish.
I know, I'm just agreeing in a very...
Well, in terms of, because I'm doing Capcom first. I want to see, I personally, like, I know we just went Devil May Cry characters, but... I really like Virgil. I'd like to see him come back, but if I didn't have a choice and like if I had to be stuck with it, like I'd be okay with Dante as well. But I personally would like to see Virgil because I really like Virgil. The Lady and Virgil.
Can we have Virgil from that modded version of DMC with the Spanish and the mustaches and stuff?
Oh yeah, Raptor Virgil. That going. T-Rex actually, you know Virgil. What? Scratch that. I don't want Virgil or Dante. I want DMC Dante. I want Dante. included with T-Rex Virgil.
I'm surprised you're not mentioning more like Street Fighter characters.
I was going to. I wasn't done yet.
He's not done. He's got
I'm
a
not
lot
done,
of
bro.
Shit.
He's got a whole list. Go ahead. Read it.
I'd like to see Cammy come back for obvious reasons because I love Cammy. Because she was in Marvel 2 and I thought that was pretty decent in that game. Maybe Jury as well, in terms of Street Fighter characters. Maybe get one of the newcomers from 5. Get Rashid, maybe, in there.
Rashid.
Get a representative from 5, because I think that'd be good. You got Viper in Marvel 3. Why not get somebody from 5, you know? This one's probably one not too many people know or remember. I want Lin Kurosawa from the Alien vs. Predator game, arcade game that Capcom made.
Go ahead, Jeremy.
You got her in
keep
fucking,
dreaming.
Like, what was it? Cannon? What the fuck was that game with Cammy?
Oh, Cannon Spike.
Yeah, you got. That's it. Be happy with that.
Next thing I know, you want that black dude from like Cadillacs and Dinosaurs or whatever the fuck that game was called.
Get the fuck out of here with that. No, I know it's a far. It's a fucking Far Cry. Like that's a long shot. But Lin Kurosawa is so cool. Like,
you know what Capcom character I like to see? The JoJo's from that JoJo's game.
Oh my god.
Jotaro?
We already mentioned some of the other ones. Jin Sao Tome is one. I'd definitely like to see him come back. I think he's an important character, honestly. It's kind of sad because no one cared about him in his own game. People cared about him in Marvel vs. Capcom. But I think he's one of those characters that needs to come back.
He falls in the same category as like Captain Falcon. No one knows about F-Zero, but everyone knows he's a ballin'-ass fucking Smash character.
Exactly. Strider, I feel like we'll see again. I'd like to see Strider, because apparently they still have the rights for Strider. Because, fun fact, Strider's not really originally a Capcom character. They just made the games.
Oh. Never knew that.
I would... Yeah. I think he was originally a manga character. If I remember correctly. I gotta look it up. Confirm. I'm sure someone in the comments or someone in all of two of our viewers will correct me. But either way, Strider, some other fucking cool characters that I liked from Resident Evil, Wesker, I wouldn't mind seeing come back. In terms of if they brought someone from Darkstalkers, Morgan, obviously, maybe Dimitri. I feel like Dimitri needs some love. The only crossover game he was ever in was fucking SVC Chaos, and that game is fucking garbage. Yeah.
What are you talking about? It was the best game ever.
Oh, fuck that game. But, I'm sure I'll remember others later that I really want, because now I can't for some reason think of them. I had them memorized, and now I just can't fucking remember. Got it memorized. Shut up! Don't say that to me.
Got it memorized.
But anyway, in terms of Marvel... I like to see the Sentry. Sentry's super cool. He's pretty much Marvel's Superman, but he's like fucking stupid ridiculous.
Huh.
Not to the level of Superman, but
that is.
but he's pretty ridiculous. He's cool. And he's also, like, I think mentally retarded, too. But, I think, if I remember reading correctly,
Batman make Cody cry hurt.
Batman, did you go make Batman go boom, boom?
Boom!
So, we're gonna, so for characters, we're gonna get Major Glory, Valhalla, the Improbable Crunk.
Yeah, I'm gonna sandbag that one, too. Anyway. Anyway,
Monkey.
Star-Lord would be cool since he's relevant.
I do not like how you kick so high. I do not like it, Samurai.
He's very relevant to the MCU right now, so why not have Star-Lord, you know? And they're coming out with a new Guardians of the Galaxy movie. Guardians of the Galaxy.
Oh, you think Rocket Raccoon will make a comeback?
Oh, for sure. Rocket Raccoon will come back. Hey, do I want him? No, but I'm pretty sure.
hey, Jeremy.
Rocket Raccoon, this weighs more than me.
Hey, Jeremy. Yeah. Hey, Jeremy. How we doing on that, the top four or whatever in the Pro Tour? You still got that up?
Yeah, they got maybe about two more matches, but these two matches are gonna be long as fuck.
Damn, they're going hard.
Yeah.
Alright, go ahead.
But anyway, fucking Black Widow, I wanna see, Scarlet Witch, fucking Howard the Duck. Bring in Howard the Duck.
Oh my god,
please
are you
no.
serious?
Please no.
I'm fucking serious.
No.
Bring in Howard. If we can get a talking raccoon, get Howard the Duck.
No, one Howard talking animal per duck. Franchise. Or per, like, company.
Hey, guess what? These are my choices. Fuck off! I'm just kidding.
Well, it was also my choice to tell you're fucking stupid.
No, yeah, kidding. You're right. It's also my choice to tell you, fuck off!
Oh, man.
Yeah. But, Nova, Howard I want to see come duck. Back. I, for obvious reasons, want to see Nova come back. He's literally one of my favorites in Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3. So, power of the Nova Force. Right, Jeff? Power of the Nova Force. Troy Baker, power of the Nova Force.
The Mega
power
Nova Force.
Power of the Nova Force. It's so fucking annoying.
You're just mad. Just mad because your ass is old.
Damn right I am.
Mad because your ass is old.
He's super cool. He's a super cool character.
Yeah, super cool when you're winning.
But, oh, by the way, now that I think about it, like, there's two...
Classic
like,
Jill? Yeah, I know.
No. You should have said that yourself, fucking idiot. No, I'm kidding. Anyway, there's Nova. Yeah, but I think the version of Nova I want to see is the new version, the different, the one that they got going on in the comics right now, which is, I forgot his name, some the Hispanic kid.
Yeah.
He's cool. I like his design, because I think that design for Nova is pretty dope.
He has, like, a bucket head.
Yeah, that's the point. That's just Nova in general. It's a bucket. It's literally a bucket. He calls himself Buckethead in the game. But, I also would like to see... I know, like, we're gonna get Spider-Man, obviously, but if they ever decided that they wanted to do maybe multiple Spider-Men, do Miles Morales Spider-Man. I think he's super cool. He's got his own unique abilities. He's not quite like Peter Parker, but yeah, he can web-sling, yeah, he can do all that shit and wall-crawl. But he also has that whole fucking sting that can stun you. And I think he can blend in with an environment or go invisible. I don't remember.
That's pretty cool.
So, I thought he wasn't like super strong like Spider-Man was though.
No, he's not as strong, but like he can still lift shit up more than abnormal, like more than normal people. Like he can still lift heavy objects and do more than a normal person could. But he's not I don't think he's as strong as Peter Parker is. But he's got his own set of unique abilities, which is why I wouldn't mind seeing a Miles Morales Spider-Man. Like, if they were just like, ah, fuck Venom. We can't put Venom in the game. He's not relevant. I'd be like,
here's Black Spider-Man.
You got White Spider-Man and Black Spider-Man. Have fun.
What about Spider-Ham?
Sandbagging. Good thing to do. No, I'm just kidding. Anyway. But that's me personally. And villains, if I can think of villains, and I'm thinking about it,
I even think about villains.
Sigma, I'd like to see Sigma in terms of the Capcom. I wouldn't mind seeing Sigma come around.
Sigma and Thanos, fucking working together. They're the two bad guys.
With a game with Infinity Stones, you best believe your sweet ass you're gonna see Thanos.
Yeah, but Thanos and Sigma working together. Thanos is going to destroy the physical world and Sigma's going to destroy the robotic world, aka the digital I'm going to be a virus.
That's something I personally I want to see, you know, like
Sigma's interesting though. That would be cool.
In terms of villains. Dormammu. I want to see Dormammu come back. I love Dormammu.
Dormammu. Power, power, I want power. A bargain.
Yo, Dormammu, where are the snow globes at?
Oh, you didn't see the movie. You didn't see the movie, did you?
No, I didn't see it. Okay. I know. I hear about the whole bargain thing, yeah. But no. But I'd like to see Dormammu.
I came here
I'm
to
sure
bargain.
Dormammu was in the movie, I'm assuming.
Yeah, he was like the villain.
Okay. Was he cool? Did he have a flaming head?
Bro, he was like a big ominous head that like flashed multiple colors.
Oh.
The whole thing was like, he was like, they like he ruled over a realm with no time, and fucking Doctor Strange used like, spoilers, the Eyes of Agamotto. Am I saying that right? I'm not saying
Agamotto.
That right. Yeah,
Agamotto.
And like, which had the time stone in it, and Dormammu would keep killing him, but he set it up just beforehand to like reverse time, and Dormammu was like, what is this? What's going on? And he was like, I'll keep killing you. And then like, he got tired of it because he got introduced to time. So he was like, fine, I'll leave you alone. Fuck you guys. I'm out. He even put up a fight. He just fucking died constantly until he got tired.
So what was he? Just a big giant looking humanoid looking head?
Yeah, pretty much. It was just his head and like in the clouds, kind of like they did with Galactus and fucking Fantastic Four, but he actually saw like a face. They had like glue like multiple colors.
That's lame.
Yeah, I was hoping for a flaming head too, trust me.
That's super lame. No, Dormammu, I like the whole story of Dormammu is he doesn't have like a physical body. I get that, yeah. Which is why he made that body and like that you see in Marvel vs. Capcom 3. That's a made up the body he made for himself. It's because I guess he doesn't.
Yeah,
have
he wanted to look cool.
He doesn't have a physical body in our realm, so he made up a fucking dimension. Body. I mean, I guess sense if he's in his own dimension. Did you say the Chaos Dimension?
Yeah.
All right, shoot breath. Oh shit, we should probably pick this up because they're on Grand Finals. Yeah, that's it for me. For characters. That's pretty much what I wanted to cover mostly for Marvel's Capcom Infinite.
Cool.
It looks great. I'm excited. I'm pumped. I know everyone else is pumped, I hope. If not
pumped to get my ass whooped.
Yeah, you
the,
are.
The hype was real as soon as Mega Man came out of that grave.
Yeah, that's what they started the trailer with. That's the best part about it.
Mm.
Is that they're just like
he's
they
got all these ass whooped.
They knew what was up. They knew what was up. Capcom was just like, yo, let's make this trailer for Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite. Mega Man X. Started off with him walking.
X fighting Iron Man's Repulsor Blast with his fucking, like, Buster. That was weak. He could do
it
better.
It was kind of weak.
He could that do
was,
better.
Well, they both can do better. They were tiny little blasts. Mm-hmm. Like, Iron Man needs to pull out the fucking proton cannon.
I feel as though they took that...
Can't even shoot a beam like that?
I feel
like,
as though they took that trailer and, like, kind of, like, made it, like, quick. Because Mega Man was very emotionless.
It probably was a quick thing, but
yeah,
it still looked fine to me. I thought it was fine. It was cool.
Yeah, I mean, I like shiny. It. Looks sexy.
But yeah, it's a real game. It's happening. It's a real boy. It's Marvel, baby. It's time. We're finally getting it. So,
oh, no.
Thanks for listening to another installment of the TurboSelectDX podcast. This time with Marvel's Capcom Infinite. Tune in next time for whatever we decide to do next.
Join
even...
Jeremy, Jeff, Fred, and Matt.
Yes. Thanks, guys. See you later.
No problem. The,
Turbo Select DX's first official live reaction via voice.
Oh, recording audio too?
Well, no, I'm not showing the audio. I gotta always get this shit later. Shut up, Jeremy.
Okay, so as an appreciation, that's what Fred's doing, right?
We'd like to show you the video. All the show in the video.
I'm behind. I don't see a video yet. Gameplay
video trailer. No, they're not showing it yet. Versus Capcom Infinite. No, they're walking off stage with his Iron Man shirt. Everything went black.
Marvel baby.
Oh my chest.
I see this shit. They contain content inappropriate for children. Hide your kids. Hide your wife.
Let's go.
Okay, looks good.
Oh my god. Oh, did you ever go for like that? Ooh. No emotion in that face. No emotion in that face.
What?
Yo, stop playing games and show us like other characters. Oh my god.
Those hits are so
hard. Oh! Oh! Oh my god. The one dude in the crowd. He sounds like Goofy.
Oh, God.
More.
Your character? Character? Can't hear you. There we go. See you again
in 2000. Someone's like, take my money.
Thank you very much, everyone.
Street Fighter 5 killer. I like that. This one dude in the chat, horny.
Bro, they have the actual tag mechanics you were talking about.
Bro.
Just tag and big combo.
I really hope this is like actual like two player versus two player thing going on too. I really hope.
Probably.
Anyway, guys, as you just heard, that's us reacting live to the Marvel's Capcom Infinite trailer.
I thought we weren't recording one.
We are recording. What are you talking about? I said I was going to record. Jeremy's embarrassed because he actually like he came a little bit.
I did actually. Yo, Captain Marvel is new bae.
Captain Marvel's new bae. So what you think, Jeremy? What you think?
Oh my god, bro. That shit looks beautiful. It looks great, actually. You can see that there are some carried over assets from Marvel 3.
It looks like shit. What are you talking
like, did
about?
Did you see Iron Man do his fucking level 3 super from Marvel 3? It's like, all my power hitter.
It's my son of dust. But Hong Kong.
Oh, yeah. Firebrand comes back, actually. It's funny.
Well, if you watched the trailer, Jeff, you would have saw that Firebrand is back.
Also, to be fair, just I noticed you were just like, look at Mega Man's emotionless face.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure that's just early gameplay footage, because, like, they did that same exact shit happen with Street Fighter V with Nash.
Yeah.
There was a couple scenes when they revealed him. Like, he had, like, his face was, like, just making weird looks and emotionless. And then in the final game,
Jeremy,
it's like, he actually has emotion.
I'm gonna have to disagree. He's making an emotionless face because he can't deal with the shit that Capcom's putting him through. They're like, yo, we neglected you for like 20 years, but we need you, son. And he's like,
see,
whatever.
I was gonna say, he's an emotionless face because he's dead inside.
he's like, y'all didn't call me in 20 years, and when y'all call me, I'm getting my ass beat by this Miss Marvel bitch.
Y'all motherfuckers haven't said anything or called me forever. And the fun time you finally call me is to get my ass beat? Nah.
I know these people. I know about these people in Marvel, man. They're so strong. They're strong.
Captain Marvel, she fucking hits hard, man.
Ryu's got that fucking the dungeon mode, like fucking Shinku and Duken up in the air and shit.
Oh, that was the power stone. That was because of the power stone, bro.
Yeah, no, but I'm saying like from the Marvel 3 in general.
Oh my god,
that was
dude.
Sexy though.
That shit was sexy.
That's cool. So at least the shit we talked about is confirmed. Like, I don't want to be like those guys who are like, oh yeah, we made that prediction and blah blah blah. But like, I mean, we weren't far off. I mean, that's nice. Everything. I'm so excited too because like everything I said about like the whole 2v2 thing, like two players versus two players, is like it seems more likely now with the gameplay that they showed us. Because it looks like it's a mixture of Marvel 3 and fucking Street Fighter Cross Tekken.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Where's my taunt button? Oh, what? It's on the fucking little pad?
Taunt button.
Yeah.
I gotta change that. I don't like that. That's the worst change. This game's terrible.
In case anyone's wondering, Jeff just got around to downloading his Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3 for PS4. But yeah, that's cool. So anything else you'd like to add, Jeremy?
I await patiently for more footage of Marvel vs. Capcom 3. I need to see more.
Is there anything you want to say about the Street Fighter V reveals?
Oh yeah, now that we're here, while we got it, I meant to... In our original podcast, when we originally started recording, I'm pretty sure this is going to get tacked on, we were going to talk about Street Fighter V. I'm going to just run through it real quick, because I forgot to mention it. Fucking... Akuma was revealed. Akuma looks great. Plays like how he usually does with some new stuff. New V-trigger, new fucking V-skill. Two supers, fucking greedy asshole gets two while everyone gets one. And then they showed off fucking five. They didn't show off. They showed five silhouettes, similar like how they did with the first wave of DLC characters. They showed five silhouettes, and they're just like in quotations. It's like five completely brand new characters, and I'm to the series or whatever. So it's just like brand new characters as a series. Fuck you, Matt. You ain't getting Makoto or Sakura.
Fuck you.
I ain't getting DiCaprio. It's okay.
DiCaprio.
Well, they said five new characters, so...
They said brand new characters in the series.
Yeah, so I don't know. Is it gonna be, so, I don't think it's going to be returning characters this time.
It might not be, but who knows? I don't know. Maybe it's just wordplay. Maybe we're wrong. But they showed that. They showed brand new characters. The silhouettes of brand new characters. Five new ones. Who knows who they're going to be? Unless until they say it, who knows? Or it gets leaked. You know, that Capcom CEO that Matt keeps talking about is like, go ahead, leak it. Go ahead, do it. Maybe that'll happen. Who knows? Maybe more Marvel footage will get leaked. Bro, I'm there's so much to take in today. There's so much. Oh.
That's the sound of Amanda's jizz himself. Yeah. Was it good for you, Jeremy? It was good for me.
It was great.
I'm so excited. I gotta go beat my wife now. I'll be right back.
Yeah, me too. My imaginary wife. Hold on, I gotta go to Ireland real quick.
Oh, what you know? Oh!
Also, it's great seeing Mega Man get his ass kicked.
Fuck you.
Yeah, Mega Man sucks. Mega Man's pretty terrible as a character.
See, I was just playing. I don't really.
Oh, no, I'm not serious.
Wait, hold on. There was some shit in that footage that I saw that was weird. Mega Man has a fucking weird ass upshot. I don't know if you saw that in real life? No, like, he arced it. That shit was arced. Did you see that, Matt?
I'm gonna have to watch it again.
Well, remember what they did with Ryu in Marvel vs. Capcom 3. Remember, finally, he could shoot his Hadouken up as a super.
Maybe, but I don't know.
It was just cool. You remember how hyped we got when we saw that? It was not shit.
Like, I was honestly hoping that Mega Man would, like, in one of his, like, a level 3 super or whatever, would just get his fucking ultimate armor and just fucking do crazy shit. It's okay, I guess. Cool. But anyway, that's my thoughts. I'm excited. It looks cool. Street Fighter V is going to be great still, continuing to be. There's a list of changes. There's too many changes to the characters. By the way, Matt, I gotta show you those changes later, because apparently Karen sucks, like, way harder now.
No! Why?
Why the fuck do you care? You don't play it anymore.
Don't matter. She's, like, the only reason I play that game.
Well, I don't know if she sucks way harder, but she's just not as good. They took some things away, changed some things. It's okay, everybody got a nerf in some way or form, in some shape or form or another. Mika got hit hard, like real fucking hard. You know, you can grab them and then throw them across the screen, dash, back dash, and they come back to you. That shit don't work no more in season 2. They took that away. You can't do it unless it's in the corner. It has to be in the corner. You can only do that. You can't do it mid-screen, which sucks, but I don't really play Mika like that anyway, so it's fine. I got Cammy and Juri. And Juri can only get better. If she somehow gets worse, then I'm going to be like, what the fuck are you doing? She was already really bad. But yeah, there's a list of changes out there that people are slowly discovering for Street Fighter V. Akuma looks cool. I saw gameplay of Akuma. He looks good. That's about it.
Fucking grizzly fucking lion ass. Akuma having ass. Fucking.
And half of that is a beard. He's got a beard.
Yeah, this shit's so weird the way it just goes. Like, bro, like, why does he decide to cut his hair sometimes? And sometimes it's like, nah.
I think it's weird, too, because, like, this takes place before Street Fighter 3, and he's just gonna cut that shit anyway.
Stop.
It's gonna be Street Fighter 3 time. It's like, time to cut my hair and revert my moveset back to normal.
None of this critical art bullshit.
Exactly. Even though he has that super in Street Fighter 3, you can choose to choose. I think you can do it.
When he, like, he fucking smacks the ass in the world.
Okay. The world is like, huh.
He's like, before this, he's like, you've been a bad girl!
the fucking slap heard across the galaxy.
Speaking of Akuma, man, like, I'm surprised none of us brought him up for character predictions. I mean, he pretty much is, like, the birth of...
We did.
Okay,
we did.
Never mind.
We did. We brought him up. You weren't listening. I don't think so.
If you were talking, I definitely wasn't.
Because we were just like, I think it was Jeff. Jeff brought up Jeff.
Oh, Jeff was talking, definitely. No, I was
kidding. Are we still recording?
Yeah, we're still recording, nigga.
Here at TurboSelectDX, we like to shit all over Jeff, particularly Matt. shit all over Matt in return, so it's okay.
No, here at TurboSelectDX, we like to have one person say one thing about Matt, and then we all just fucking say, even though Matt's been acting the same way forever, hey, fuck you guys, I'm going home. Go ahead. Reek it.
Yo, real talk, Fred, Jeff, isn't Matt such an asshole? He's such
an
asshole.
Wow, Fred, what are we paying him for?
Yeah,
you don't pay me at all, you son of a bitch.
All right, that's enough of that. We're done. We're out of here. I got a lot of information to take in right now.
TurboSelectDX out.
Peace. We out.
We out. Peace.
Marvel. Support the scene.